In our last video, we went through the steps to develop a linear regression equation. In this video, I'd like to use that equation to answer two questions. I want to use the regression equation to estimate the tuition for Sunshine University in 2005 and 2010. If you look at our original data table, you'll notice 2005 is missing and 2010 is missing. However, by using the regression equation, we should be able to estimate a value for 2005 and 2010. Now, if you remember from the previous video, we developed the parts to the linear regression equation, and I believe I rounded to the nearest hundredth to get an equation that looks something like this. So back to our question. We want to know the tuition in 2005 and 2010. Well, you have to ask yourself, 2005 is how many years past our base year? Remember, our base year was 2001. So 2005 would be 4 years past 2001. 2010 would be 9 years past 2001. So in our regression equation for 2005, we're going to replace the x with a 4, and we're going to replace the x with a 9 to estimate the tuition in 2010. And we have something that looks like this. And now we're going to just use simple algebra to solve for y in each of these equations. When you solve for y, these are your results. So what does this actually mean? All right, well, the estimated tuition in 2005, which is 4 years after 2001, will be approximately $3,715.95. The estimated tuition in 2010, which is 9 years past 2001, should be approximately $4,757.25. I took the liberty of redrawing our table, and I've inserted 2005 to show you 4 years past 2001, this is our tuition. And in 2010, which was 9 years past 2001, this was our tuition. I'd like to take a moment to note that I did highlight 2005 and 2010, just so you realize that this is estimated data. This is not actual data, right? The information we have for 2001, 2004, 6, 7, and 8, that was actual data that was supplied by the university. For 2005 and 10, we used our model or our regression equation to estimate these numbers or these values. These values can also be verified by using the table feature of our calculator. So this would be a good time to get your TI graphing calculator. So if I press second and table, okay, I want to go 4 years past 2001. So if I scroll down, you can see I'm at x equals 4, which corresponds to 2005. And then I highlight the column, the y column, and it gives me 3,715.94805. Remember, we're going to round to the nearest hundredth, so I would make this 0.95, right? $3,715.95. And if you look at our table, that's what we found, $3,715.95. And now let's scroll down to x equals 9. So this corresponds to 2010, right? 9 years past 2001. And notice, if you look at the Y column, you're only going to see it goes to the nearest tenth. So if you actually highlight the column, then you get all of the decimal places below. So again, we're going to round to the nearest hundredth, so we'll call this $4,757.25. And again, that corresponds to what we found, $4,757.25. There's one last thing I'd like to point out. The data that we developed for 2005, or the tuition value that we came up with, is an example of interpolation. This is because this data falls within our given data range. We were given data between the year 2001 and 2008, and 2005 falls in between 2001 and 2008. So it's an example of interpolation. And The 2010 data is outside of our given range, so it's an example of extrapolation, right? Remember, we were given data from 2001 to 2008, and so 2010 is outside of that range, so it's an example of extrapolation. And that completes our lesson. So after watching the three videos, you've learned how to create a scatter plot, you've learned how to develop a linear regression equation, and in the third video, you've learned to use that regression equation to answer a few questions. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.